Hey home networkers, are you ready to tackle the Wi-Fi dead zones in your home? If so, today I'm going to be showing you how you can take control of these Wi-Fi dead zones by setting up a Wi-Fi extender in just a few minutes. The Wi-Fi extender I'm going to be setting up today is a TP-Link AX3000, but keep in mind that regardless of the make and model of the Wi-Fi extender that you buy, the steps for setup and configuration will very much be the same. In order to get started, you only need your Wi-Fi extender, and then you also need to know what the Wi-Fi network name and password is that's being broadcast by the router in your home network. Once you have everything on hand, the next thing you need to do is you need to get the Wi-Fi extender ready to be set up. Take it out of the box. Usually what you'll see, the antennas might be folded down. So it looks like this. On the back of the device, you can see here, it's meant to plug into a power outlet. So the first thing that we need to do in order to set up this device, we need to plug this Wi-Fi extender in close to where your router currently sits. So here, conveniently enough, I have my router right next to me. It's plugged in. All the lights are showing that it's broadcasting its Wi-Fi signals. So now I'm gonna take this device and plug it into an outlet that's nearby. Okay, here behind my desk, I have a few open outlets. This is actually the power cord to my router. So I know by plugging my Wi-Fi extender into one of these outlets, it will be close enough that we'll be able to easily set up this device. The reason your Wi-Fi extender needs to be close to your router is that it needs to receive a strong Wi-Fi signal from your router in order to initially configure. So what we're going to do, we're going to plug this device in here. You will see that the lights start to flicker on the device as it sets up, and we're going to wait until that top power light is a solid blue before moving forward with the configuration. All right, it took a few minutes, but that top power light now is a solid blue, so we can move forward with the configuration. Okay, so we have a few different options here for connecting our Wi-Fi extender to our router. You can use WPS or Wi-Fi protected setup. Many of these devices have a separate application you can use for setting up the extender. For example, TP-Link has the Tether application, or you can use a cell phone or another mobile device like a laptop to connect these devices. Because some people might not have WPS enabled on their router for security reasons, and depending upon the make and model of extender you buy, you'll have a different application that might work or function differently, I'm going to be setting up and connecting my Wi-Fi extender to my router using my laptop, just so that way everyone can follow along and follow these steps to set up their device. Okay, here we are on my laptop. As we saw on the Wi-Fi extender, it has a solid blue power light. As a result, it is now broadcasting its own Wi-Fi network. So in order to connect our router and Wi-Fi extender, we need to connect to this Wi-Fi network that our extender is broadcasting. So here we go down, Wi-Fi connections, and as you'll see, TP-Link extender is showing up here. So we're gonna select connect. Okay, now we're connected to the Wi-Fi network of the extender. What we next need to do is open up a web browser. With an internet browser open, we now need to access the settings for our Wi-Fi extender. Depending upon the make and model of the device that you buy, this might be a different location, but for the TP-Link AX3000, we need to go to 192.168.0.254 and hit enter. On this page, you're setting a password for the settings of your Wi-Fi extender. This is something that you want to be secure and that you'll be able to remember. You don't want this to be easily guessable because you don't want anyone else to be able to access the settings of your Wi-Fi extender. Once you type in your password, select start. On this next step, your Wi-Fi extender will scan for available Wi-Fi networks. It will run through this scan, show you what's available, and then you'll need to select one of the Wi-Fi networks that your router is currently broadcasting. Okay, so here's the case for me, Network from Home 5G. Let's select that one. We need to enter in the password for that Wi-Fi network, so I'll do that now. The next thing it's asking for here is the 2.4 gigahertz Wi-Fi network that my router is broadcasting, so it can expand that as well. This Wi-Fi extender expands both the 5G and 2.4G networks, so we need to put the password in for this Wi-Fi network as well. Now your Wi-Fi extender is going to reboot after it's established its connection with your router, and then you should be in pretty good shape when it comes to setting up your device. At this point, we're now given the instruction to unplug our Wi-Fi extender and then plug it back in a location that's closer to the Wi-Fi dead zone where we want to provide Wi-Fi access. It's very important to remember here that this Wi-Fi extender needs to be able to communicate with your router. So it needs to be plugged in a location where it still receives a strong Wi-Fi signal from one of your router's Wi-Fi networks. So I'm gonna go do that now. I'm going to unplug my Wi-Fi extender, plug it in a different location. We'll give it a few minutes to boot up until we see that blue power light being solid again, and then we'll take it from there. I should also mention here that because I have a TP-Link router and a TP-Link Wi-Fi extender, when I set up my extender, it automatically set it up in one mesh mode. That's because the make of these two devices is the same. One mesh mode just provides for a more seamless Wi-Fi communication between the two devices. If you have a different manufacturer for your Wi-Fi extender and your router, you probably won't have this option for one mesh or a mesh mode. So I'm gonna turn this off here just to show you what it looks like for everybody else. And as you can see, it's going through the configuration to turn the extender into standard extender mode. Also, because my extender was configured in one mesh mode, I didn't have the option to change the Wi-Fi network name that my Wi-Fi extender broadcasts. I should be able to make those changes once this device reconfigures and reboots in Wi-Fi extender mode. Okay, here we are. If I go to wireless settings for the TP-Link extender, extended network. Now, because the device is no longer in mesh mode, it's in standard Wi-Fi extender mode, I have the ability to change the Wi-Fi network name and password that's being broadcasted from the Wi-Fi extender. This is all personal preference. Just keep in mind that one of the knocks on Wi-Fi extenders is that if you make the Wi-Fi network name and password the same that's being broadcasted by your router, your devices still might have trouble switching over to the access point that has a stronger Wi-Fi signal. Conversely, if you make the Wi-Fi network name and password different from what's being broadcast from your router, you'll have to manually connect every time you want to connect to the Wi-Fi extender's Wi-Fi network. This might not be a problem if you're infrequently switching from one Wi-Fi network to the other, but just keep in mind it could get annoying if you're doing this on a frequent basis. I'm not going to change anything with my Wi-Fi extender's Wi-Fi network settings at this point. Let's go to the location where I plugged in the Wi-Fi extender, make sure it's working properly, and just verify that we're good to go. Okay, here we are at the location where I set up my Wi-Fi extender. As you can see here, all the lights are blue, everything looks good to go. If this device was too far away from your router, this would be a red light, or you would get some indication that it doesn't have a strong Wi-Fi signal with your router. And in those cases, you'll need to plug your Wi-Fi extender in a location closer to your router. If you can, you want to implement it in a location that has a clear line of sight to your router. If you can't do that and you have to implement it on a different level of your home, if you put it directly below your router or not too far away, you should be fine. But it looks like we're all set with this location here, so we don't have to change anything. At this point, everything looks okay with our Wi-Fi extender. The next big test that you might want to look at is going into the location that you previously had a Wi-Fi dead spot. Try to connect to your Wi-Fi extender and see what your internet connection is like. See if you've actually solved the problem of cleaning up that dead spot in your home. Of course, if you want to get really scientific here, you can use a Wi-Fi analyzer in that location to see what your Wi-Fi signal strength is. You can also run a speed test to make sure you're getting adequate bandwidth to the internet. All of these things will help you determine if your Wi-Fi extender is in a good location or it's actually solving the problem you want it to. I'd love to see in the comments section how you're implementing Wi-Fi extenders in your home. And if you're now up and running as a result of this video, please give it a thumbs up just so it gets shared with other people. As always, thanks for checking out this episode from Network From Home, and we'll catch you on the next one.